It's the holiday season, a time to celebrate with family and friends, but not everyone is in the holiday spirit, no matter how much they want to be. In fact, more and more people are just downright depressed. 4 in 10 people suffer from holiday depression. And Tricia Greaves, president of the Nelson Center for Emotional Healing, is joining us tonight. Thank you so much for coming in, Tricia.
Thank you for having me.
It's great to have you here. So I guess the question for a lot of people is, the holidays are supposed to be cheerful and happy and a time of family, so why is it so emotionally difficult for a lot of folks?
I would say for 3 reasons, actually. Primarily, for one, we all have expectations, right? We're going to have a good time. We're going to have fun at the party. New Year's is going to be the best ever. So we have very high expectations, and we don't usually meet them. And that's one reason. Another reason is that people oftentimes during the holiday time begin to compare themselves to other people, or they feel as though, gee, I don't really have as many friends as I thought I did, or what's wrong with me? You know, I'm not invited to that many parties. And so we
it's like a social barometer even.
Yeah, we get a little concerned, like maybe I don't have I don't have the friendships I should have. So we sort of judge ourselves a little bit. And then I'd say the last thing really is that holidays bring up feelings and really memories of loved ones who have passed, or relationships that are no longer. And so we get a little blue thinking about, you know, people we miss, our relationships we wish we had or that didn't work out. And so we reflect on that. And that can all these things together create these negative, you know, depressive emotions that bring us down.
And so it's like, here we go again, entering the holiday season. Let's take a look at our whole past.
Yeah.
You know, it's like the ghost of Christmas past,
right?
With Scrooge and all of
yeah.
that. So how do you maintain like a happy and healthy outlook when you start entering the holiday seasons to kind of like battle that and cut it off at the pass?
Well, I find, I mean, just for me personally, many years ago, I decided that I wasn't going to try to have a good time at certain times, especially New Year's. Like, I called it quits on trying to have fun. You know, just plan something that's simple and easy. I mean, if you go to a party, great, but don't try to build it up as it's going to be amazing. It better be amazing. Just let it be another day. And I say that for all different holidays where we have these expectations. And then when you lower your expectations, you can be pleasantly surprised. Maybe something wonderful happens, and then that's a bonus. But you're not setting yourself up for disappointment. Another thing is really, reaching out to other people. We tend to, you know, do a lot of self-reflection, and we get, you know, sort of self-focused, self-obsessed, and that can bring us down in a heartbeat. So thinking of other people, thinking of how we can maybe help somebody else come out of their
blues. That's what I was wondering about. Well, or just volunteering at a food pantry or a food shelter or one of the other shelters around town, or the like Toys for Tots, any of these charities.
Yeah.
When you look at your life versus what somebody else is struggling through, you start thinking, man, I'm pretty blessed.
Absolutely. You know, getting anything we can do to get out of ourselves, reach out to somebody else, help somebody else have a better day, or a
right.
whole lot of people through these volunteering opportunities, that immediately takes our mind off of ourselves and our troubles. And you can't help but feel better when you're helping others.
It does. It makes you feel so good inside. And then you kind of go through that cycle, which is a much better cycle to be in.
Right.
You know, and a lot of my friends, they always, you know, they are just crushed by, oh, I got to get this done, I got to get that done.
Mm-hmm.
And they put things off, and it all comes crashing down at the last second.
Right.
And so aside from the reflection and kind of comparing yourself to other folks,
mm-hmm.
you've got this weight of, I've got to get this and this and this done. I haven't
right.
shot for this person or that person. So I have always thought, just start early and then kind of go through it. Just make little checks off that list of yours.
Absolutely. And also, again, it comes back to expectations. You know, give yourself a break. If you don't get all the presents, you know, out and wrapped or under, you know, out in the mail or whatever. My family, a lot of them are scattered across the country, so I have to do a lot of, you know, going to the post office. But give yourself a break. If you don't get the holiday cards out, it's okay. You know, send them in January.
Right.
You know, just relax a little bit.
Right. That's what I ended up doing a couple times. They were like New Year's / St. Patrick Day cards.
Right, yeah. Why not?
But with a festive Christmas theme.
Yeah. So, more people will see them because they're not, you know, stuffed with a whole bunch of other holiday cards.
There you go. Another bright way of looking at that. It's a good spin. All right, Tricia Greaves, thank you so much for joining us.
Thanks
today.
For having
yeah,
me.
We appreciate it.